Let's focus on the differences between its centralized and decentralized operation. In this video, we will address the principles of centralized and decentralized control in microgrid. We will cover some of the key attributes that affect the performance of the control algorithms, and we will highlight the advantages and disadvantages of both the centralized and decentralized schemes. When the internal microgrid control is performed in a centralized way, a single entity is in charge of carrying out the decision-making processes. This kind of architecture is suitable when all actors in the microgrid have common goals. In conventional power systems, centralized control is generally performed by a single entity at the transmission system operator level. Similarly, in the case of a microgrid, when applying centralized control, also a single entity carries out the economic dispatch and the unit commitment calculations. The set points are provided to the distributed sources by the distribution system operator or by a microgrid central controller. A microgrid central controller can be described as the controller that determines the set points of the loads, distributed generation and storage units. A microgrid central controller can be managed by the distribution system operator itself or by a dedicated microgrid operator. In a decentralized control scheme, the internal microgrid control takes place at each controllable element in the microgrid. Negotiation among the different actors may take place, especially because in this case, the different actors have different goals. Common aspects and calculations like load forecasting, state estimation, and security monitoring can still be conducted in a centralized way. The performance of the control algorithms depends on the following four key attributes. First, the number of nodes. The distributed generators and controllable loads that make up the microgrid affect the complexity and computational time as the number increases. Second, the number of messages exchanged. The distributed generators and loads in microgrids are usually dispersed, and the communication systems at low voltages usually have limited bandwidth. In several cases, the number of messages required to perform a task is of primary importance. A decentralized control approach reduces the number of messages. Only a small part of the information is transferred to the higher levels of the control hierarchy. Third, size and structure of the system model. The structure and complexity of the system needs to be considered. Decisions taken by different actors might not only increase the number of nodes, but also impose extra technical and non-technical constraints. Fourth, accuracy and optimality of the solution. The convergence and accuracy of the solutions depends on the type and accuracy of the algorithms used and the input data. Let's now discuss the advantages and disadvantages of centralized and decentralized control. Centralized control schemes have the following advantages. First, they provide a high operation knowledge, where the main goals are clearly identified and achieved. They can provide global optimal solutions, they allow an easy synchronization to the main grid, and they can effectively use real-time signals for online operation. Decentralized control schemes have the main disadvantage of being very complex with respect to multi-ownership and competition between various actors or agents. This is due to the fact that each agent seeks to achieve its own objective, such as maximizing its profits. Decentralized control schemes also have important advantages. They are suitable for fast-changing infrastructures, and they are easily expanded because of their plug-and-play capabilities. Also, they have high reliability. The main disadvantages of centralized control schemes are that they are computationally expensive and time-consuming. This is due to the fact that the central controller needs to run an optimization problem that takes into account a large number of distributed generation units, loads, and storage units. Additionally, this central controller has high communication requirements, leading to additional costs. In summary, today we highlighted the main characteristics of centralized and decentralized internal microgrid control. In centralized control, a single entity, the microgrid central controller, optimizes the operation of the microgrid. The microgrid central controller assigns its set points to the loads, distributed generation, and storage units in order to attain the microgrid's goal. In decentralized control, the decisions are taken locally and negotiations take place, or may take place, as the different actors usually have different goals. Today, we also address the four key attributes affecting the performance of control algorithms, being the number of nodes, the number of messages exchanged, the structure of the model, and the accuracy and optimality of the solution. Finally, We discuss some of the main advantages and disadvantages of each control architecture. On the other hand, centralized schemes have the advantages of having global optimal solutions. However, they are computationally expensive and very time-consuming. On the other hand, decentralized schemes provide high reliability and are easily expandable, although they have the disadvantage of being complex due to the multi-ownership and different goals from the actors. In the next video, we will focus on the decentralized control schemes in more detail.